breezy countryside in Tuscany, where I have the pleasure of interviewing our clients, Brendan and Sheelagh O'Connor, who recently purchased Villa Peraio, which is now being transformed into a prestigious resort and yoga retreat. We'll see you at the property. Okay, so here we are with our clients, Brendan and Sheelagh O'Connor. It's a pleasure to be here today. Also joining us today is Brendan and Sheila's consultant, Roberto, and our wonderful assistant, Anna. So can you guys maybe start off by telling us a little bit about yourselves, where you're from, and then maybe what you currently do for a living, previously and currently?
So originally, I was born in Hong Kong. So I lived in Hong Kong until I was 18, went to boarding school in England, and then from England, I worked in the City of London for 2 years, and then I left the City of London to go and work in Luxembourg, thinking I would go back to Hong Kong after a couple of years, you know? And so I got to Luxembourg in 1987, and I'm still in Luxembourg, 35 years later. And then I met Sheelagh in Luxembourg.
Mm-hmm. I moved, brought up in the north of England. Moved to Luxembourg in 95, and yeah, a year later I met Brendan, so then we got married, had kids, started coming to Italy on holidays when the children were small, local to here, and we just fell in love with the place and came back every year. And then after a family event, tragedy, my mum died, we said, you know, we've always had this dream to move to Italy. So let's do it now. Why wait?
So we'd always had this thing in our mind that we wanted to buy something in Italy, and originally we didn't really think of it as a business idea. It was originally just we would buy for ourselves, and so we thought we'd maybe then have like retreats, you know. And then we're looking, we're thinking, oh, you could maybe do with yurts and things like this, and we had all different ideas, but we never really considered it as a real business venture. It was more a case of it would be for us. And then when we made the decision we were gonna buy somewhere, we went on the internet, you know, looked at all different loads of websites. I had read up so much about how you have to be so careful, that there's a lot of fraud and people saying it's for sale and it's not for sale and blah, blah, blah. So I was a bit nervous. So I wanted to find an agency, you know,
more secure.
Great Estate, we found actually quite a strange way. We found this property, and it was on a Russian website. And I emailed them and said, oh, you know, is this like kosher? I didn't quite. And they were affiliated somehow to Great Estate. And so they said, oh, you need, we can help you, but, you know, the agency is Great Estate. So then I went to Great Estate direct.
Okay.
Found
which
it on.
Which is how,
yeah. And then I sent an email and said, hi, you know, this we want to come down and have a look.
Tell us about your idea, your project for this property. Where did you start your research? How long did you research? How long did you?
Well, we've been coming for so many years. We sort of know Italy is like a little gem. It if you come here with families and stuff, it's wonderful. But it's also wonderful if you come here as adults because, you know, the wine, the food, the countryside, it has everything, really. So for that side of it, we'd been here coming for 15 years, so we knew, you know, we knew how beautiful and how wonderful it is and how friendly the people are. So we didn't really have any, we didn't do much research on that side. On the business side of it, we know how popular the Bikram yoga is, the hot yoga is, and we know that there's nothing like it in Tuscany.
No.
There's no studio. So it's sort of like, it all sort of fitted. We just do it, we'll do this, you know. And now, I mean, then we looked around at properties and stuff to get comparisons, you know, because there are so many agriturismos, which are great to go to with your families and stuff like that, but we didn't want to have kids. We've had our kids, so like we wanted to have more of an adult sounds wrong saying.
Yeah, we wanted to go more for the luxury.
Yeah,
it's a little retreat.
Yes.
It's not a hotel. It's your own little
estate
that you can come, and there's plenty of spaces around. You can go and meditate, find some quiet time out.
Was this always the dream? What the idea was always, I guess. Dream to purchase this property and
The dream was really just to buy a property for us. And then in 2012, Sheelagh, basically we had three young kids.
Sheelagh had a bit of a burnout and just was like, oh my God. And discovered the yoga. Mm-hmm. And within 6 months, I went to the training in LA. So I left him and the kids, 9 weeks. It was really tough. It was really tough. It was fabulous. It was the best thing I've done for myself as an adult. Fantastic. Anyway, it came back and a year later opened a studio. So none of this was a kind of ever a plan to do yoga, you know. I've always been sporty, but and then go running. I never found anything. So this yoga anyway caught me and basically changed all of our lives, really.
Can you tell us what was it about Il Peraio that really sold you on the property? What made you fall in love with this property?
The driveway, straight up to the villa.
Yeah. As a little boy, I remember saying to my father, I'm going to have a house with a long driveway. And my father, he lived in Northern Ireland, and they had a house, and they had two lions like this, mm-hmm. and the driveway, and a fountain. And I said to him, I'm going to have a house with a long driveway. And he was like, yeah, all right, son. And it was something I always, and then literally, it was like it was fate. When we saw the video, because the video and the kids, they'd say, oh God, Daddy's watching that video again, because the music. There we go. He's watching the video again, Mummy. And I'll be looking at it. And so before we even came to see the property, I reckon I could have told you everything about this property. I knew. I had gone on Google Maps. I measured sizes. I'd done everything.
Yeah,
but not just this property.
Not just this property. He always asked a lot of questions.
I wanted to know what I'm getting into. And then when we, literally, the day that we arrived here, it was the driveway, wasn't it? The driveway and the steps. But also the house and also...
First impression.
Yeah, first impression is the big thing. And also, our Italian friend said to us, it had to be high. Mm-hmm. It's high. And the fact that it's close to the motorway is actually a blessing. Because if people are travelling, you need to have reasonable access. The train station is great connectivity to all of where you want to get to. Mm-hmm. With the high-speed trains and everything. It sort of all worked. It just, everything was like, it was like it was meant to be.
And then the vista.
Yeah.
Every aspect.
Like, I sit here
sunrise
now.
Sunrise over here.
It's beautiful. I sit there, the sun sets, it's beautiful. I look over the pool.
We sit and have dinner out here.
I sit at the back.
Cortona.
Yeah, Cortona. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it was like it was meant to be. And it was like it was fate. And
then you have a bit of very nice agricultural land.
Yeah.
Not
absolutely.
Too much.
Yeah. Not.
Yeah.
I have a question for Roberto. How many properties did you all look at? And then how did it go when the negotiation process, when you finally decided to settle on this house?
We actually probably didn't see in person a lot of properties. We had a lot of conversation, email, phone calls on this property particularly. He asked a lot of questions. He was, let's say, a little bit concerned of the Italian purchase procedure,
because
so he wants to know a lot of as many information as possible on this, especially just to be prepared already, maybe to go for an offer or to go for the purchase. And I remember explaining many, many things and sending many long emails, but I think they have been very helpful, and every time, I think it was very receptive.
Receptive is
the right word. And one thing, probably we picked up at the end 3-4 properties.
Yeah. I found it useful because on the website, a lot of the properties had, probably because of COVID and everything, a lot of the properties had videos. So drone videos and videos of the properties. And so actually I got an awful lot from that. So that meant for me that I didn't need to personally go and see too many of them. I sort of picked a couple and said, right, these are the ones we want to definitely see. We were already, I would say, 95% sure that Peraio was the one.
This was the one.
Yeah. So we wanted to go and see this, and we saw, I think, the one in Città del Pave.
One in Città della Pieve and one in Cetona. So basically, I mean, everything went really smooth at the end when they decide, I mean, to go for Villa Il Peraio, because I think in the previous 2 months, or 1 month and a half or something like that, we have done a really great job of collecting all the relevant documents to be and provide all the information both to the buyer, potential buyer, was Brendan and Sheelagh, and also to the vendor, I mean, to get them ready maybe to receive an offer and to have all the documents ready to receive an offer and to be ready to sell. Okay. So we have done, with my colleague Giacomo, we have done a great work as well with the technician of the vendor, Alessandro, which was very helpful also during summertime, August, to prepare a very detailed technical report on all the things to be rectified, I mean, which were not probably ready to be compliant under and relevant under the Italian law for the purchase procedure. So,
I mean, that's the thing for someone who's looking to buy. Like I recommend now to everybody who asks me about buying, I tell them to contact Roberto at Great Estate, purely because that was actually I'm quite maybe I'm difficult, I don't know, but I want to have everything lined up. I want to know the ins and outs from the start. As long as you're clear with me, then it's no problem. As soon as I think I'm being messed around a bit, it's like, you know.
Well, I think obviously when you're purchasing a property in a foreign country, you know, in this case, Italy here, obviously there's many things to do. Do you feel like Great Estate at Roberto, do you feel like he helped you with, you know, through the process, through
hugely,
all the steps?
Hugely. I mean, the fact that English speaking was a huge plus, obviously. you know, we needed to set up a company here, so Roberto recommended a commercial lister, who, funnily enough, used to live in Luxembourg. and then banking, you know, to sort out the banking. And, you know, you do read horror stories of people trying to buy in Italy and having a complete disaster, you know. And for us, all of those processes were made simple because of Roberto and because of Anna and because of Great Estate, because of what they offer as for a client. And really, that's what you need. You need that. If you don't have that coming here, you can get yourself in all sorts of trouble. But really, all of that side of it has gone really smoothly.
Good.
You know, and we're more than happy with Great Estate, like really happy, you know.
Can you tell us how Miss Anna was helpful? How Anna helped you?
Well, you see, of course, you don't realize it, but when you buy the property, then you have all of the utility bills, and everything has to be switched to your name or the company's name and all this. And it's very difficult if you don't speak Italian, because in Italy you speak Italian.
Especially by phone.
Yes.
Maybe if you go to a shop, it's different, but
but there's not so much multilingual.
In the smaller villages,
it's Italian and that's it, which again is part of the beauty of it, you know. We needed to have someone that would help us with all of that, and Anna did all of the transferring of utilities, and like, it's a minefield.
And Anna was fabulous.
And Anna came with us, and
Anna came in and worked her magic
time and time again.
Yeah. And at one point, Anna, because we had all the documents, but then they wanted certain ones translated and this and this, and then in the end, we got everything together, and Anna sent an email, a peck to the Questor, and said, "We have all these documents. Do we come now? Because we don't want to come a fourth time, and you say no, we want something else. Is this enough? Is this correct? Yeah. You know?" She was really good, and they said yes.
Well, which you need to be. You need to be firm. You need to
be. A foreigner purchasing in Italy is gold dust. You know, the fact that the agency can offer all of that, that is a huge, huge benefit for the buyer. All of that was really smoothly done. All the work behind that, we don't see as a buyer, because all we see is we like the house, we make an offer. That's it. We don't see all of that, you know. Then, so Roberto takes care of all of that. And that was all very smooth, which as a buyer, you do expect that, right? But what you don't necessarily expect is all of the other stuff, which is when...
Kind of the after sale.
And those after stuff is, I think, a massive selling point for Great Estate. A huge, huge selling point.
Would you recommend Great Estate?
Of course.
To friends, to foreign clients looking to purchase, obviously, Tuscany, Umbria, in Italy in general?
Yes, in Italy, yes, because you need to have some... You need to have a point of contact that can help you with everything you need.
But also it was personal as well. It was like, it was the personalities, it was the kindness as well.
Yeah.
You know, it was like, it was more than a job. You really helped us.
Yeah.
And when we were frustrated over this and that.
If I have one regret, and it's not a regret that's about Great Estate, was I know Great Estate on their thing, they offer that they can help recommend builders and workmen and all that. And I never took up that offer, or never approached Roberto about it, because we thought we had that covered via a friend.
Okay.
And I didn't want to waste time for Roberto to do that. My one regret is that I didn't do that. But you need to have an estate agent who is going to go beyond and help beyond, and Great Estate does that. You need to have an estate agency that will go that extra mile for you.
And our goal is to, ideal goal, every time is to try to make the purchase procedure for foreign clients as a smooth process, which is not easy because there is a lot of work on the back.
Yeah.
But you shouldn't see that. I mean, you should only, you know, be part of a nice journey. Of course, there are some moments of
difficulties,
friction, frustration. But I mean, they can be easily solved. No, we are not talking about.
Because you have to remember as well, foreigners that are coming to buy in Italy, they're buying a dream. You are buying something. It's your dream. For most foreigners, it's a dream purchase. And so you need to keep that sort of focus, that dream alive. The smoother the process is,
the better.
The better.
Because if you have a bad experience, obviously, then
the dream every time we come down here from Luxembourg, it's like, wow. And it is, I just look round and I go, this is the dream, you know? And that is most people who are purchasing from another country are purchasing what they have in their mind as this sort of dream, you know?
So, guys, I think that's all the time we have for today. Cool. I think we have to wrap up.
Cool.
Thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much for sharing with us your experience and your new project for this villa. We're very excited. We'll be waiting for the opening. And thank you, of course.
The opening party.
We'll be a big opening party. When we're up and running and ready, come and see and take a yoga class. And
of course.
Have a sauna.
And thank you to Roberto and Anna, of course, for being here.
Thank you.
And thank you, as always, for everyone for tuning in. We'll see you at the next Great Estate interview.
Thank you.
Thank you.